Hello and welcome to the learning video on Introduction to Flipped Classroom. I am Dr. Payal Dande from SVKM's NMIMS School of Pharmacy and Technology Management, Shirpur Campus. Let us understand the learning objectives of this learning video. After watching this video, you will be able to understand what is flipped classroom, why is it considered as an active learning strategy, and how can you use it to teach your own course content. A flipped classroom is an instructional strategy. It flips or reverses the traditional teaching learning method. It gives content information to the students prior to the class and expects students to go through the same and come up with queries. Then in class, the students are given problems based on the concept. They are expected to apply the concept knowledge to solve the practical problems under the guidance of teacher. The teacher has to help the students in practical application of the concept knowledge during the class. So this is how the whole picture looks like. It's exactly opposite to the traditional teaching method. So before the class, what has been expected of students and teachers? The teacher is expected to give the handouts in the form of information or learning audio-visual videos to the students to understand the concept. The students are expected to go through the concept and understand the whole content. There are also few assignments which are given in between, which can be completed by the students to understand if they have understood the whole concept. Now they have to come prepared to the class. Now let us see what happens inside the class. During the class, the teacher first clarify all the queries which are being brought by the students inside the class so that everybody is benefited out of it. And then the teacher gives the problem based on the concept to the students either individually or in groups to solve the same. By the time the students are solving the problems, the teacher moves to the inside the class and tries to see that everybody is doing the job. Similarly, they also help to the students who require it. Later, the students check their understanding of extended learning by giving additional assignments. So the teacher gives additional assignment to the students which are at higher levels, and they are being submitted by the students, and the teacher evaluates to understand the learning that is being made by the student. So basically, one has to flip the lectures out of the class and carry the practical learning activities inside the class. Now let us understand what are the requirements or what is to be done by a teacher and students for carrying the flipped classroom. So let us first see what needs to be done in the form of out of the class activities. The teacher has to prepare and distribute handouts to the lectures, or they have to prepare a learning audiovisual videos of lectures and give it to the students. They can also use some learning videos which are available freely on learning websites and distribute the same to the students for learning. Now they have to ask the students to watch it attentively before coming to the class. Ask them to write their queries, questions and bring it to the class. Give some small assignments based on the same to confirm their understanding on the topic. So this is what a teacher has to do before the class is being taken. Now let us see what the students are expected. The students are expected to watch the learning videos or read the content knowledge that has been provided by the teacher before coming to the class. So they have to come prepared. Similarly, they also have to write their queries, questions and bring it to the class so that that can be solved during the class. Complete the small assignments that were given in the learning reference material so that the teacher understands that the student has gone through the content and they have submitted the same before coming to the class. Now let us see what is being expected of a teacher to carry during the class, which is known as in-class activities. So the teacher has to prepare a list of queries that were submitted by the students and address them during the class and clarify it for all. Similarly, they have to give students some practical problems which are based on the same concept. They have to set time for individual as well as group activities. Teacher has to assist those who require help. The teacher has to move in the class and evaluate the group activities to keep a check onto the students. At the end of the class, everybody can summarize the solution with justification. There could be some more assignments which will be given by the teacher to have an extended learning on the similar concept. Now, what is to be done by the students during the class? They have to come, first of all, they have to come prepared with the concept knowledge and apply this concept knowledge to solve the practical problems. This has to be performed either individually or in the form of group within the set time limit. They have to justify their answer with reasons, share their understanding with the class, and learn by each other's experience. So now, think as a student, take a pause, take 5 minutes, and understand if this strategy is going to help in effective teaching learning process. If your answer is yes, then explain how. And if your answer is no, then explain why. Give at least 3 points in justification of your answer. Hope you have done this. Now let us summarize the concept of flipped classroom by talking about its advantages. Flipped classroom is an active learning strategy because it helps the students in learning process. It helps engaging students in active learning. It uses, secondly, the most important, it uses the technological knowledge to build content in a pedagogical sequence. So whatever learning videos which you make or printouts or handouts which you give, basically you use technology to build the content in a very in a complete hierarchy and in a pedagogical sequence. So this helps learning better. It helps the learners to learn at their own pace because they will be having handouts or learning videos with them, which can be once again seen later whenever they require to understand the concept. So it helps the students to revisit the concept several times to understand it effectively. The out-of-the-class assignments will also help the students to re-evaluate the knowledge or understanding which they have acquired on the course content. It also helps teachers to assess the theoretical and practical learning that is being made by the students. It's time for self-evaluation. After watching this video, ask yourself, am I now able to understand the concept of flipped classroom? Can I now analyze why is it called an active learning strategy? Can I use it in teaching the course content of my domain? If so, which topics can be taught more effectively using this strategy? Thank you. To learn more about why and when should you use flipped classroom strategy, watch our next learning video 2.2. Namaste. For any queries, suggestions, kindly email at payal.dande@gmail.com. Thank you very much.